But if I can move the conversation on to an unfortunately less sunny but nonetheless important topic here, let's talk COVID-19 and medical oxygen, because this is undoubtedly still the biggest talking point of the industrial gas year, of anyone's year. And we have seen some truly tragic, distressing and unprecedented scenes around the world. But of course, many of those shocking scenes were in India. And I know that you, Rav, have not only been there on the ground in India this whole time, but you've also been working hard to help with coordinating and securing critical oxygen supplies into the country. If you can, would you be able to share your thoughts with us on that and perhaps where our industry goes from here with oxygen?
Great, thank you. Thank you, Rob, for that question. In fact, the truth is that the entire industrial gas industry in India has been at the forefront of trying to help the situation and alleviate it. So there is no reason that the single out thing has made a big impact. All the industry came together in a way that we've never seen before, and that's perhaps been the silver lining in all of this. It's been a difficult year. You know, we all thought 2020 was going to be the hard one and celebrated the 31st of December as the end of an evil year, but it ended up being the dry run to the real test that came in 2021. And I leave the assessment on whether the government could have done better to all of the international panels that will assess the situation. The reality was the second wave came, it came like a tsunami. And the truth is, no matter how prepared you could have been, the way corona impacts demand on hospital resources, be it ambulances, beds, access to ventilators, and finally oxygen, the sheer peak that corona gives you in every city means that no matter how well prepared you are, you're likely going to face a crisis similar to what New York experienced in May 2020. The government, with the lobbying of the industrial gas body in India called AIGMA, 12 months ago, in fact, allowed for industrial oxygen to be diverted for medical use in the event of an emergency. And so they were quite proactive in that. And when the second wave came, peaking in April and then in May, the capacity of oxygen in India actually quadrupled as a result, or went up five times almost as a result, because a lot of oxygen was diverted. The challenge we had in India was that the infrastructure is challenged at points. And so you had tanker trucks, LOX tankers that were put on trains. They were called oxygen expresses and moved between cities because it was much faster to do that by train. So you have an incredible imposition on demand and an industry that has not been able to forecast such a big surge in demand, because we've never seen a black swan event like this. Which meant that we had to think of other creative ways. So there was ISO containers that were put on ships. There were ISO containers from Singapore and Dubai and the Gulf that came on planes. Many, many countries supported India through the process, including the French government, the German government, the American government, sending oxygen plants. France, for example, is sending 55 oxygen plants from two companies. There's Nowhere as well as Mills. And my own company is supporting Mills to be able to install PSA plants in hospitals, which we're doing at the moment and will continue to do over the next 2 months in preparation for a potential third wave. I often say that the graph of corona went up and came down in India on the second wave, much like a Bitcoin. So it comes out of nowhere, goes up and comes back down, and you can't really explain how that happened. There is talk of a third wave, but it's quite heartening to see the amount of investment that's been made both by government and also the industrial gases industry in India to help the country prepare for a third wave. No one can say what it will be. We were all experts on corona in 2020 thinking it'll go away, and here we are again in 2021 thinking the second wave is it and we're ready for a third. But this pandemic has a way of surprising everybody and making all the experts look like idiots. So I can't tell you what will happen, but I can tell you that it's heartening to see the industry came together. It's heartening to see how all differences were put aside and all companies, big and small, whether they were oxygen resellers, oxygen fillers, or the large syndicated multinational companies, came together to help the country through this. And as an industry, on behalf of the industry in India, I'd also like to say thank you to all the global players that helped India through this crisis.